After 2 years of minimal playing time, DJ Wilson broke out in his third year at Michigan. The redshirt sophomore played fewer than 10 minutes a game in both his injury-shortened true freshman year and in his redshirt freshman season in 2015-16. However, Wilson shone in a larger role as a redshirt sophomore, averaging 11 points, 5.3 rebounds, and 1.5 blocks per game, including fantastic shooting with 54% shooting from the field, 37% shooting from beyond the arc, and 83% shooting from the free throw line. Wilson was especially spectacular in postseason play, especially during the NCAA tournament, where he averaged 16 points a game with nearly 43% shooting from beyond the arc and 3 blocks a game. His shooting touch, ball handling ability, and defensive upside make him a great fit for the Brooklyn Nets. Draft Express's most recent mock draft has Wilson as the 27th pick, and he would be a solid choice for the Nets if he's still on the board. DJ Wilson has all the tools to be a solid complementary offensive piece from his first day in the NBA. He is a brilliant cutter and scored 15% of his baskets on cuts during his most recent year at Michigan. In addition to his solid cutting instinct and smooth jump shot, Wilson's AAU days as a wing player have left him with a guard-like handle and an ability to shoot off the dribble that would rival any stretch big man in the modern NBA. On the defensive end, Wilson has the potential to be an elite pick-and-roll defender. He has the fluid athleticism of a wing player, but at 6'10" with a 7'3" wingspan, he has the size to switch on to bigger players while still being able to guard players on the perimeter. His defensive instincts are far behind his offensive instincts at this point in his career, but he has the lateral speed and leaping ability to switch nearly every pick and roll at the next level. Wilson already showed at Michigan that he is a great weak side shot blocker, and Kenny Atkinson could easily mold him into a pick and roll destroyer on the defensive end. The biggest issues with DJ Wilson are his frame and poor rebounding ability. While Wilson's skinnier frame helps in terms of his lateral mobility, it also leaves him vulnerable to being bullied in the post by larger players. Additionally, his poor rebounding make him a very questionable fit alongside Brook Lopez. While Wilson will be able to add some bulk at the next level, his rebounding instincts are more of a problem. Wilson's lack of rebounding instincts may not be as much of an issue if he is a bench player, but it does limit his upside, at least as long as Brook Lopez mans the middle for the Nets. While Wilson might not fit well as a starter right away, his skill set would be a solid fit for Brooklyn as a bench big man. He could form an interesting tandem up front with Trevor Booker as an undersized center. Alternatively, Wilson could potentially play as a stretch five against some bench units. Kenny Atkinson would have to carefully monitor his minutes to avoid forcing Wilson into guarding bulkier big men, but Wilson's potential switching prowess and floor spacing would be a big boost to any Brooklyn bench lineup. DJ Wilson's potential skill set is nearly a perfect fit for the modern NBA. He could potentially slot into the starting lineup immediately, but would definitely be a benefit to Brooklyn's thin big man rotation coming off the bench. He would be an asset for any team as a rangy combo forward. If the Nets can get him with the 27th overall pick, he would be able to find a role right away within Kenny Atkinson's offense. Additionally, he would have the potential to be a game changer on the defensive end. This is Nick Agar-Johnson, signing off for Brooklyn.com.